morning to all my dear students. Welcome to today's online classes. Here in the whiteboard you can see I written something pre-midterm exam. That means your exam will be going to be held in future. Mentions are the some syllabus of your maths textbook. Chapter number 2, numbers up to 1000. From the textbook you can see chapter number 2 is there, that is numbers up to 1000. Chapter number 3, addition. Chapter number 3, addition. Chapter number 4, subtraction. Chapter number 4, subtraction. So these three chapters, it will be coming in your pre-midterm examination 2020-2021. Okay, these are the syllabus, these are the chapters which is coming, going to come in your pre-midterm exam math syllabus. Instructions for pre-midterm exam. Here I some instructions are there. I am reading. Questions for the pre-midterm exam will be as MCQ pattern. Questions for the pre-midterm exam will be as MCQ pattern. That is multiple choice questions. Questions will be there. Which related to that, 4 or 5 options will be given. From that, you have to find out the correct answer and tick the correct answer. Okay, that type of questions are multiple choice questions. There are multiple options are given and you have to tick mark that correct answer. Multiple choice questions. Second, all the questions of MCQ pattern will be from inside the above mentioned chapters. The chapters which are given as a syllabus, from that chapter itself, from inside that chapter, the MCQ questions will be given to you. Also, PDF notes which are uploaded in the school website. PDF notes are given. It is in your school website, available there. Go through it and also from the three chapters given. Next, expected date of pre-midterm exam is from 17th August. I'm repeating, expected date of pre-midterm exam is from 17th August and soon the dates will be uploaded in the school website and you will be updated by the dates of the pre-midterm exam. It will be, the date will be uploaded in the school website. You can go through it and get the dates of the pre-midterm exam and timetable. So children, for this, be prepared for your pre-midterm exam. You have to prepare by itself by today and for every subject, not only for maths, for every subject pre-midterm exam is coming. So be prepared. Okay children? So children, here some questions are given. See, this is the questions of abacus. Do you know abacus how to do? Yes. Question 1, revision questions from your chapter number 2. Count the beads and fill in the boxes. Here in the form of abacus, you know the place value 1s and 10s, 2 digit number. Yes, let us revise it again. Here in this way you have to fill in the 10s and 1s place. Okay, and 3 options are given for every question. You have to see the correct one and you have to tick mark that option. Starting from the first question. Here, 2 spikes are given, okay, 1s, 10s, yes or no, 1s and 10s. So, you have to fill the numbers, that what will be coming in 10s and 1s place, okay. What will be coming in the 10s and 1s place, you have to tick mark that option. Starting from the first question, how many bits are there in the 1s place, first count that one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is the bit? How many bits? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means it will be coming in 1's place and 10's. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. So we get the answer as 76. So which is the correct one? A, answer is given 25. B, 76. C, 88. Which one is the correct answer? Where is 76? Yes, B. So this is our correct answer. So we will put the tick mark like this. Okay, our first question is completed. Second question, see children. In the ones place, do you see any beads are there? No, na? So it means ones place is empty, put it 0. then we come to 10th place. Let us count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We get the answer as 9 tens. It is in overall 90. So what is the number given in the option? Whether 90 is given? Well, yes, A. In the option A, 90 is given. So we will put tick mark on the option A, 90 like this. Okay. Next question. See how in the ones place, how many bits are there? Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 bits are there, so 9 ones. Then in the tens place, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 bits are there. 4 bits are there. So we will put 4 tens like this. We get the answer as 49. Okay. This 49 can we find in the option? Tell me, can we find in the option? A 45, B 13, C 49. Yes, 49 we get. So we'll put the tick mark like this. Our answer of the third question is 49. Okay, children? Children, two more questions are there of the same topic. Let us do it. Start from the ones place, then go to the tens place. Okay? Let us start from the ones place. Count the bits with me. How many bits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 bits are there. Okay, in the tens place, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 bits are there. So, 8. Okay, tens and ones place. 89. So, do we have 89 in the options given here? A 40, B 36, C 89, D 72. Yes, 89 is there. So, 89 is the correct answer. Put a tick mark like this. Next question. In the ones place, count the number of bits. 1, 2. 2 ones. Then in the tens place, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 number. 7 bits are there. So we get the answer it as 72. Okay. Do we have 72? Yes, it's A option has number 72. 72 is the correct answer. So in this way, you have to count the number of bits, whatever given in the ones and tens place, and fill the correct answer, tick the correct answer like this. Okay, children. So, children, these questions are there. 3-digit number. Do you know 3-digit number? It contains ones, tens, and hundred. Ones, tens, and hundred. So, we will solve these questions. Count the number of bits and fill in the boxes. Here, you have to count the number of bits starting from the ones place, then tens place, then 100 place. Let us count with me, children. In the ones place, do you find any number of bits here in the ones place? Do you find? No, no. So, in the ones place, nothing is given. So, our ones place, the number will be 0. Then again, coming to the tens place. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 is there in the tens place, so 9 tens. Then next hundreds place, 1, 2. 2 bits are there, so our answer comes as 290. Do you find any option here, 290? Yes, 290 is given in the option B. So our answer is 290. Tick mark that number, option B, 290. Okay, next question. Hundreds, tens, ones. Do you find any number in ones place? No. So, in the ones place, the number will be 0. And again in the tens place, do you find any bits are there? No. Again, it will be 0. Then in the hundreds place, bits are there. Let us count. 1, 2, 3. 3 bits are there. So, we will write down in the hundreds place 3. So, our number comes as 300. Do you find 300 in the option? 5, 13, 124, 782, 3 and yes, 300 is there. So, we will put the correct mark, tick mark in the option D, 300. Question number 3. In the ones place, how many bits? 1, 2. So, in the ones place, we have the bits 2. In the tens place, we have the bits 1. In the hundreds place, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 5 bits. Okay, so our number comes as 512. Where is 512? Yes, in the option D. So, our answer is option number D, 512. Next question number 4. In the ones place, how many bits? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 beats are there. So, 1's place 8 beats. In the 10's place, 1 beat. Okay, in the 100's place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 beats. So, our answer number comes as 918. Where is 918? Here, it's given in the answer option A. 918, we'll put the tick mark like this. Okay, children? Remember, children, about the place value? Okay. Let us do some questions of the place value, okay? Question, give the place of the underlined digits. You have to find which place the numbers are, if the underlined digit, which place it belongs to, okay? Let us do with the first question A. Number is 96. So, in the 96, our underlined number is 9. 9 digit is underlined. So, its place value is 1's, 10's. So, what is the place of the 9? 10's. So, in which option will you put the tick mark? 1's, 10's or 100's? As 9 belongs to 10's place, so put the tick mark over the 10's option. Second question, 6060. Again, starting from the, this is 0 comes in the 1's place, 6 comes in the 10's place. So, this 0 is underlined. So, 0's place is 1's. So, put the tick mark over the option 1's. 75. 1's, 10's. 7 comes under the place of 10's. So, our answer will be 10's. 48. Underlined digit is 8. So, it comes under the 1's column. So, a place value of 8 is 10's. Here, 3 digit numbers are there. It means 1's place, 10's place and 100's place. Okay. 1's place, 10's place and 100's place. The digit underlined is 5. 5 comes under 100's place. So, we'll put the tick mark over the option 100. Next, 729. 1's place, 10's place, 100. So, 9 comes under the place of 1's. It comes under 1's column. So, our answer will be 1's. 140. 1's place, 10's place, 100. 1 comes under the place of 100. So, our answer will be 100. 626. 1's, 10's, 100. 2 is underlined. This digit 2 comes under the 10's column. So, the place will be 10's. 923. 1's, 10's, 100. The digit underlined here is 9. So, it comes under 100's column, 100's place. So, 100 will be the correct option. Like this, you have to solve the questions of the place value and underlined digit. Okay, children? Children, here some more questions related to the place value are given. Let us do it. The digit at the hundreds place. The digit at the hundreds place of the number 712. That means you have to find what is the number given in the hundreds place. So count with me. 2 comes under 1's place, 1 comes under 10's place and 7 comes under 100's place. So what is the number coming under 100's place? That is the number 7. So, our answer 7, where it is given here in the option A. So, put the tick mark over the option A, 7. The digit at the 10's place. That means in the number 459, you have to find the 10's place. Okay. What is the 10's place here? 1's, 10's, 100. Yes or no? 1's, 10's, 100. So, our number under the 10's place is 5. Where is the option of 5? Here, put the tick mark in the option B, 5. The digit at the 1's place. That means in the number 625, you have to find 1's place. 1's, 10's, 100. What is the number given under 1's column? 5. So, our answer will be 5. Option number C has 6 10's and dash 1's. So, 8 comes under 1's place, 6 comes under 10's place. So, what is the number in the 1's place? 8. So, what is the option here? 8 is here? Yes. We will put the tick mark over 8. 48 has dash 10s and 3 1s. So, this 3 is of 1's place and 4 comes under 10's place. So, this 4 will be will write down here 4 tens. And what is the option? 4 is there? Yes, 4 is there. So we'll put a tick mark. 243 has 2 comes under hundreds place, 4 tens place, and 3 ones place. So ones place is not there. We'll write down 3 ones. And what is the option there? A. 3 is there. So we'll put a tick mark. Our 3 ones place, 3 number, the digit 3 is been given. Okay, children? Understood? Next question. Give the number writing figures for the following names. Here, the numbers, number names are given. That means spelling, names are given. You have to find the which number is that. First, 140. How to write 140? Write down 1, then 40. 140. What is the option? 120, 140, 112. So our answer of first is 140. We'll put a tick mark over the option B, 140. Second, 793. 793. 93 have to write down 93. So our option is A, 793. 803. 8. And how to write down 303. See children, here no tens place is given. So in that place put 0 and then 3. 803 where the option, yes, option number C, 803 is given. Next, 518. 518. How to write down 18? 1 8. 518. So do we have option 518? 512, 520, yes, 518. We'll put the correct answer 518 like this. You have to do the number names and what in the figure how to write down. We have to choose the correct answer and tick mark over that correct answer. Understood children how to do it? Let us do the next question. Which is greater? Which one is greater? Here 4 options are there. So how to do? First see all the options. 730, 4, 7, 15, 785, 777. First see the place value starting from here. Each has the first number 7. So every number is same. Next 3. Second number here 1. Here second number 8. Here 7. 3, 1, 8, 7. So among these 4, which one is the greater? 3, 1, 8, 7. 8 is greater. So the whole number 785 is the greatest number. So, in this way, you have to find which one is the greatest and you will have to solve. In the same way, you have to see the smallest number if it is asked and then solve the question like this. So, our answer is 785. Okay, we will put the tick mark over the 785. Next question, which is the smaller? Which is the smaller? Write down the numbers in the rough side like this. Okay. First, see the first number, 6 is there, first number 2, first number 4, first number 1. So, among the 4, that is 6, 2, 4, 1. Which one is the smaller number? Tell me children, which one is the smaller? 1. So, this whole number 135 is the smallest number, smallest among the 4. So, where is the option? Yes, 135. So, we will put mark here. Tick mark, and that is 135 is the smallest number among the 4. Now, in the same way, do this question also. Fill in the box with correct symbol. Greater than, lesser than, and equal to symbols are there. You have to choose the correct symbol, okay? 414 or 424. Which symbol, which one is the greater? 4, 4, both are same. Second number. Second digit 1 is here and 2 is here. Which one is greater, 1 or 2? 2. So which sign we will be using here? Yes, this sign. Put sign like this and this one is the greatest number and this one is the smallest number. Next, we will put a tick mark like this. Next question, 354. What do you find here? Which one is the smallest or greatest? Yes, both the numbers are same. So our answer will be equal to sign. Where is the equal to sign? Yes, option number C. We'll put a tick mark. C is the correct answer. Next, 885 and 881. Starting from the first number, 88. Both are same, both are equal. Second number 8, 8. Again both are same and both are equal. Third number is 5 and here 1. 5 and 1, which one is the greater, which one is the smaller? Children, 5 is the greatest and 1 is the smaller. So we'll put which sign here we will putting down? Yeah, this sign. 885 is greater than 881. 881 is smaller than 885. Okay, we will put this symbol. So our option B will be correct. In this way, you have to see which question, which number is greatest, which number is smallest. First, see the first number of first digit of every question options. Then second digit of every option. Then come to the third digit of every option. So clear this concept, children. So children, next question, write the short form of the following expanded form numbers. Do you know how to do the expanded numbers? Okay, first question, 700 plus 60 plus 8. How to do? 700, 7, 60, 6 and 8. Our number comes as answer 768. Option 762, no. 761, no. 768, yes, this is the correct answer. Next, 600 plus 80 plus 2. First write down 600, then 82. So where is the option 682? A. We will put tick mark. 900 plus 50 plus 4. Write down like this. 900 50 plus 4. Where is the option? C. So this is the correct. 954 is the correct answer for the question 3. 800 plus 10 plus 5. So 800 and 10 plus 5, 15. 815. So where is the option 815? This. So we will put a tick mark on the option B, 815. Fill in the missing. First question, 548. The number where it is we're saying you have to find that number. 500, we have to expand this. 500, then 48. 40 is written, then what it will be coming in the next box? Read it again. 548. 40 is written and what is left? 8. So our answer comes as 8. Where is the option of 8? This one. So we'll put answer option number A. Next, 290. 290. It means 90 will come in the tens place. Okay. 290. 290. And nothing is there. It is already given 0. Where is the 90 option? C. So our answer will be C, 90. Next, 395. 90 is given. 5 is already given. 300. We are telling in the first 300. That means we'll write down in the first box 300 and 90 already given, then 5. Where is the option of 300? Option number B, we'll put a tick mark like this. Okay, to do this question, first read the number properly. I'm repeating 395, 300, then first box 300, 90, second box 90. And what is the last one? 5. One more example I will give. 412. How to do? See. Read the number 400. That means 400 first, 412. Then 10 plus 2. 12, how you are writing down? 10 plus 2. 400 and 12, you have to write down 400, then 10 plus 2. One more example, 272. 200 plus 70 plus 2. Read the number properly, then you will able to do it in the expanded form like this. 270, then 2. Okay? So, in this way, this is the same exact pattern that multiple choice questions you will be getting in the exam. Following options will be given and you have to choose that option, which one is the correct, and put a tick mark over that option. For that, you have to have a thorough practice and do it in the rough side, how to do, or by calculating it, do the able to solve the correct option like this. So children, get practiced in this MCQ type pattern manuals and go through this video, go through your chapter itself. Okay, thank you. Today's class. Have a nice day.